You know why I take you fishing and hunting with me all the time?
Now.
It's because when I was younger, Grandpa, not the loony, used to take me out. They would all take me out hunting, fishing. They shaped how I grew up. I want to give the same thing to you.
Yeah, you teach me a lot of things growing up. How we sing, how we dance, how we anything.
I'm still teaching you, right?
Yes. You're still teaching me.
I'm going to Honda.
I'm Ian Clue.
I'm Igalila and I'm 14 years old.
I'm Lanathan with the Clue and I'm 10 years old.
I'm gonna go to the Daniel, I am 5.
And our youngest is Gawianuni, and it means that she makes it that way.
What's unique about our family is I'm fortunate enough to have the language and he has the culture aspect. So the two halves actually make a really good whole together and we balance each other out. So now our kids are able to have two worlds.
Language is so important to our family. I didn't grow up with it. That's one of the qualities I love about Governor Honda is that she grew up with the language, not necessarily the culture part of everything, but just the language. So we complete each other as a whole. So the kids, they learn the language. Then with me, I kind of do all the material, physical aspect of everything.
I had mentioned to him that when we had children, that I would prefer that they only had a Mohawk name. I always felt like people resorted to use my English name as like a way to get out of having to learn how to pronounce my Mohawk name. I didn't want that to happen to my children. I wanted them to have names and I wanted them to be proud of them. So the Andaga Nagela Zanukwizilis?
Ha.
Onagela.
And Gini Ungwahor.
Hango wid. Nua wahnizaladia ezo ta se galoriska hageta nela dinokwizilis wahe.
Ha.
Nikji. Because we keep your hair long, does it make you feel connected to your family and your ancestors?
Yes, a lot.
How come?
Because most of my family all had long hair, and it makes me feel like I'm similar like them.
Mm-hmm.
One way that we try to encourage respect in our children is by just talking, being very open with anything and everything they want to. A lot of it goes back to when we're home, we decompress with them, we talk to them, we walk through things. I know that I mentioned she has a lot of different names. Your grandma, your Dora, what was Ista's name?
Gawianuni.
And then we decided to give our baby sister the same name, huh? After Ista passed away.
I think her spirit's in here.
Yeah, maybe her spirit's in there.
Me as a father, one thing I try to teach is respect. Respect for yourself, respect to one another, respect to other people, and even respect for the land. So when we fish and we hunt, do we fish and hunt everything?
No.
No, we don't, right? We always try and leave something for, you know, the future generations, right? Same thing with, you know, when it comes to other people. You don't want to treat people mean, you want to treat people with respect, right?
Yeah.
Do you remember what those are called?
Sissies.
Sissies, yep.
What kind of sissies? Look at. How many sissies?
Tadego.
Tadego,
yeah. Asa. Your three sisters, just like what we're gonna put in our garden, huh? The three sisters, the corn, the beans, the squash. After we got the squash and we kept it and we ate it, what did we do with the seeds?
We put it in the jar.
We had to let it dry. Why did we save it?
So we can plant.
So we can plant again, huh?
You put the seeds in.
And then what happens after you put them in the hole and you water them and the sun shines on them?
They grow.
They start growing.
I try to bring it back to the creation story. There were the white, the black, the red, and the yellow. When we bring racism into that, right from there, I've told them, like, there shouldn't be racism because We're all people. We've all came from the same creator. We were made in the same manner. It's just the color happened to be different. But at the very base, we were all given a mind, a heart. We know we're not the only people on Earth. There are so many people. We learn you can breathe through things, you can be calm, you can try to take a break if you need it.
Mama grew up with the language, and Mama is teaching you the language, right? And you guys go to the Freedom School, so you guys get a lot of language. But me growing up, even though I grew up in a cultural surrounding, hunting, fishing, gardening, going to ceremonies, I didn't grow up with the language. You know, I heard it, I heard my grandparents speak it, but I didn't grow up with it because my grandparents, especially Grandma, she went through a boarding school. The people there, they weren't nice to her. They weren't kind to her, but she wasn't the only Duda that happened to. There were a lot of Dudas. So we're very lucky that we still have what we know today, you know.
For Native people, there was a lot of pain that came with boarding schools. Their language was taken away, their hair was cut, their clothing changed. So when they came back to their communities, they weren't the little kids that left anymore. They were different little kids, and a lot of the families had to deal with that pain too. We're still dealing with it, the history of that pain and the aftermath.
What are you up to, Bubba?
I'm working on a cradle board. Right, this was basically, we'll say, the first baby carrier. You know, because we would swaddle our babies and we would put them in the board.
Fixing now. Mm-hmm. You used to be in one of these.
Yeah, I know.
But one question, how long did this take you to make?
That?
Yes. Like all of
2 days?
Wow.
We're at a time here and now where we're trying to encourage to, okay, let's cope with this pain and let's move forward. Let's evolve what we still have. Let's grow. Let's talk again. Let's speak. Let's, you know, we're still here. We're not gone. We're here as a people. And to know that there's all different Native peoples, that there's Haudenosaunee, there's Navajo, there's Algonquin, just like the trees, just like the plants. There's all different kinds of trees. But they're all different, and they all have their strengths and they have their weaknesses.
We might not all look like the stereotypical what you might see in a book. I'm very fair-skinned. I have lighter hair. He's got light eyes. But that doesn't make us any less Ungwehume or any less Indigenous.
Native people today, we live just like any other people. We're individuals and we have our own languages and we have our own cultures, and some of us might not know our culture. Some of us might not know our language, and that's not a bad thing either. It's just how history, how time has treated our people.
So, more specifically, what do you want the outside people to know about us as being Haudenosaunee?
Yeah, I just want to be treated fairly, and we're going to be here for a while.
We're still here, right?
Yeah.